gentlemen, welcome to this edition of the Nosebleed Seats. I am the Mad Conservative Crime Fighter. Once again, we travel all around the Central Illinois wrestling scene to talk with major players on the independent circuit. We're going to talk to the Money Makin Jam Boyz. We're going to talk to Blake Steele. But first, we're going to talk to somebody who is actually departing the Central Illinois region. We're talking with Matt Winters, and unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to him because the fans around Central Illinois called him Wiener one too many times, and thus he warned repeatedly that he was going to leave if he kept calling him Wiener. Now he has reached the point, he's leaving. Matt Winters.
You see, now I am done with Central Illinois. I am done with the people getting my name wrong. You see, I said it clear the whole time. My name is the unpredictable Matt Winters, not whatever these other people call me. I will not be disrespected. I will not be disregarded. I am often imitated, never duplicated. I will never be welcome in Illinois. So, farewell. I'm out of here.
Now, Matt Winters, you know your last name's Winters. Very rarely did you win in this area. What do you attribute to that?
Well, you see, you say very rarely did I win, but I believe that I did damage, and I made an impact no matter where I went. Every show that I was on, even if I had lost, the fans walked away, and they said, who was that guy? Who was that? Who was that winner? Well, guess what? It's me. The only winner that matters. The unpredictable Matt Winters.
Now that you are heading out, what do you believe was the mark you left on the Central Illinois wrestling scene, if you believe you've left a mark or a lasting impression?
Well, I believe I left a very long lasting impression. I believe that no matter what, people will remember my name. People will remember the shows I've been on. People will remember the unpredictable Matt Winters. You know, I might be leaving Central Illinois right now, but this is not the last time that you will ever see me. You will remember seeing me because every time that I'm around, I'm unpredictable and you'll never forget.
What do you believe was your best match in Central Illinois for the time, the 2 years that you were here?
I believe the best match that I had in Central Illinois was probably with The Solution. I respect those guys, very good workers. I believe that both of them have a lot of talent, and there's a reason why they have been consistent tag team champions in this area. I've had multiple very well meshed up matches with those gentlemen. So my hat's off to them.
And you kind of patterned yourself as more of a chatty wrestler. Not so much the technical wrestler, but you basically did a lot of talking when you were in the ring.
You say I'm not the most technical wrestler, but this is the thing. I know how to get the job done. It might be an eye rake, it might be a jab, it might be a kick, it might be a punch. But there's a reason why I'm not as technically sound as other people in this area. I don't want you to know what I can do, because I can do a lot. I can do springboards. I can jump off the top rope. I can do submissions. I can just lay you straight out. But the reason that I'm so unpredictable is you don't know my arsenal, because I don't want you to know it. If I have to pick up a brick and hit you with it, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make sure that whenever the people leave, when they see me wrestle, they remember Matt Winters.
Is there an opponent in this area that you have liked to have gotten in the ring with that you haven't gotten a chance? Like unfinished business.
I'd say one-on-one with Sage Ramsey, if I ever got a rematch. I had a very good New Midwest match with himself. He defeated me. If I ever had a chance to get in the ring with Sage Ramsey, Sage, you do whatever you need to do. You get your back fixed, I know you have one more match in you, Sage. I would be the guy. And say Sage is done. Jason Wells, me and you one-on-one, classic.
Well, now that you're moving to the state of Missouri, is there anybody, any promotion you want to audition for at this point?
I'm not really sure what I want to do in Missouri. I know that I would love to be able to work for Harley Race at some point. God knows that's a dream of anybody that respects wrestling in the business. But I definitely would like to get into the St. Louis and Kansas City area and make myself known and make a name for myself.
All right. What do you want? I think I may have asked this question, but what do you want everybody to remember you as?
I want everybody to remember that no matter what, no matter what kind of match, what opponent, what number of opponent, what time limit, what stipulation, no matter what, the unpredictable Matt Winters is going to do something that you've never seen before.
Once you get settled in, where should promoters go if they want to bring in Matt Winters?
If you want to go, you can check out YouTube, my YouTube page, youtube.com/thenerdhurtrules, or my Facebook page. Just type in Matt Winters. I'll come right up. You can get a hold of me on there.
All right. I hope once this camera shuts off, I'll think of more questions I didn't ask you, but we'll leave it there for now, since this is your farewell party, so.
Well, farewell, Central Illinois. Farewell.
All right. Don't eat too many wieners. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Segment in our fastly approaching major wrestling event happening in Maroa this weekend, we talked to the PWG Tag Team Champions.
Alright.
Talking with the Money Makin Jam Boyz. They currently have two sets of belts. Earlier on today, there was a question as to whether they're going to be fighting for the Tag Team Championship in the evening. But a decision got declared a no contest, reversed, nullified, whatever. You've been having your problems with one Attitude Inc. of late. A match that took forever to happen, but tell us about that.
Well, they're just another one of the teams that decided to try and take what belongs to us, which is the PWG. So. They decided to get in line, and we're going to knock them down like we've done it with the other team. They got their little thing going on. They got their little faction with little Periwinkle. We saw first bit of that tonight. Well, today, rather. We saw first piece of that today. He decided he wants to get in our business, so we're going to make a six-man tag later tonight in Raw. We're going to defend these tag team titles, and they're coming home with us.
Put it this way. You know, for a long time, that me and Guy Smith have unsettled business from the back of the days of New Midwest for the heavyweight title. And now I finally got gold and he wanted to try to take mine. That ain't happening. Any way I can get him back in the ring, so be it.
We'll take it how we can get it.
You're also having your problems with one Submission Squad, or the Commission, whatever name they want, or the Commission Squad, over at PWE.
One or the other. Same guy, same outfit, they just changed the name, right?
Yeah, pretty much, and put on some ties, and pulls out a rule book, and...
Well, you know those guys, man, they definitely took us to our... To our limit, you know, they every match we had against them, it's always been they brought the best out of the Jam Boyz. So we really respect the Commission Squad. You know, sooner or later, I'm pretty sure we're about to meet them again down the road, try to cross paths again, and we'll just have to do what we do best, and that's continue to take care of our championship gold. We're all about the money. That's why we call ourselves the Money Makin' Jam Boyz. Can't get money without the gold.
But also, we got to be leery because we did have a battle with these guys at the Balloon Festival. Mephisto and Big Dave Osborne.
Oh, yeah.
We got some unsettled business with those guys, too.
Once again, another tag team that wants to step onto the plate. We're willing to take on any and everybody, all comers. We don't care. You put them up, we knock them down. That's how we look at it.
Bottom line is, we ain't never scared to put these titles up. We ain't never scared to go to any other fed to go get titles. We will take on anybody and all comers. We'll match up with anybody, any size, any type of style of match wrestling that we can do, we can match it. Bottom line.
Doesn't matter.
What other irons do you have in the fire at this point? Future opponents or future appearances?
I'm going to be making my return to IWAP here later on this month, so that's going. I'm looking forward to seeing that. That's going to be pretty exciting. We don't really have any guest appearances going on at the moment, but we are taking bookings.
Well, I supposedly getting back down with 0-1 here next month in October. You know, my ongoing feud with Barry St. Pierre for what he did to me up there. I would like to get my boy KC to have my back up there at 0-1 because with Bear, Doomsday, and Dexter, you know, those slippery, slimy characters, they're getting the best of me then. So I need my boy in 0-1 to have my back. So that way we can enough to make the tables even. And then we can go ahead and knock Bear and Doomsday out.
Open the gate, I'm coming. Right in.
Bear doesn't have his Illinois title anymore. Now, you were wanting to take the belt off of him, but now you're going to have to go to Plan B, it looks like.
That's right. And you know what happened? See, because he had the numbers game, that's why he was able to successfully keep that belt. That's why I need my boy there in 0-1 to make sure that won't happen. I can beat that. I don't need the title now, right now. I'm going to tell you this right now. It ain't all about the title. I just want to beat Bear. I just want to see if I can beat Bear St. Pierre one-on-one or in a tag match. It don't make no difference to me. I just want to get a victory over him. And I need my boy, the main attraction, KC Jackson, to have my back there in 0-1.
That's not too much to ask for. Fair is fair, you know. We know those guys don't like to play fair, and that's the reason why they keep me out. But if they bring me in and get my boys back, it'll be an even playing field, and they'll see. Bear will really see what the man can do.
That's right.
Now there's, let me go back to Doomsday a little bit. You had a tag team match against the Generation of Doom, a team that's kind of been exclusive to IWOW.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't know, it's... The tag team of the year looks like a belt race between the Money Makin' Jam Boyz, the Hooligans, and then any other team that's piling up the belts.
You know, the Hooligans, that's another team I respect that's out there. You know, those guys are doing big things. We crossed paths with them once. We'd love to do it again. Anytime, anywhere. It don't necessarily have to be in one certain place. We'll meet the Hooligans anywhere.
And I gotta admit, the Hooligans took us to the brink. We had nothing but hard matches, and they come out on top. We come out on top, barely. It's something that's gotta be unsettled there. It's like stalemate, like two bulls colliding, and we gotta get the Hooligans again to show who is the superior tag team in the Midwest.
There's one other tag team. When you won the Glory tag titles, the finals of the tournament was supposed to be MMJB versus Team Overkill, Cage and Rose. Two wrestlers of the year. Are we ever going to see MMJB versus Overkill?
Probably not, because we know those guys are scared of us. So.
They're very scared of us.
I mean, we're always ready, but apparently they're not, so you'll have to ask them that question.
That's right. They're very scared of us because they don't want none of us. We fought them before down south in AAPW, and they barely inked the victory up, and they know we took them to the brink that they've never been in a match before.
Well, yeah, I'll definitely give them credit. They did get a victory over the Money Makin Jam Boyz, but we always wanted our rematch, and they seemed to be afraid to give us our rematch. So.
And I don't blame them, because any tag team out there, they know if they face the Money Makin Jam Boyz, you hesitant to get back in the ring with us, because you know that we bring the heat, we bring the fire, we bring the madness.
One last comment about Doomsday. He's United Wrestling Coalition Heavyweight Champion. Ever think of popping up over there, since they've been running kind of weekly shows? They seem to have a lot of spots on cards that may be available. Maybe Madman should pop up at UWC in Georgetown in the future.
Well, in this business, you can never say never, put it this way. You never know when it will happen, or is it going to happen? I can't say right now, but stay tuned. You won't see something coming up here. That's all I can say on that matter.
There's always room for surprises, brother.
All right, anything else you want to plug, announce, or?
Just want to say keep supporting the Money Makin Jam Boyz, because we're here to stay. We ain't going nowhere. We know a lot of teams out there don't want to see us. They don't want to believe in us, but we ain't going nowhere. So put your money up, and we'll be right there to take it.
And let's say that I got this to say. People wonder, why are we called the Money Makin Jam Boyz when you got a main attraction and a madman? Well, let me explain. We're the Money Makin Jam Boyz because if you book us, and that goes to all you fans out there that look at this, when you book us, we make you money, because people jam to see the boys take out the competition. Thus, that's why we're called the Money Makin Jam Boyz. So any promotion, we don't care where's it at. If you want the Money Makers to come to your fan, all you gotta do is just call us, and we'll come running, and we'll bring the fire. Yay!
And what are those contact addresses for MMJB?
I can be reached on Facebook, or facebook.com/KCJackson3, or my email is kcjackson3@gmail.com.
Or you can get a hold of me on my Facebook, on my fan page, is Mississippi Madman 53 at Facebook, or you can get me on my email address, is MissyMad53@yahoo.com. You get a hold of us if you want the Money Makers, you want the crowd pleasers, and the fire. You get a hold of us, and we'll bring it.
We'll be there.
All right, MMJB. Thank you, Casey Madman.
Our house. Yay!
We're not in the house, we're on a street.
Anywhere becomes my real estate.
All right. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
For the first time ever, Amazing Kong will be coming to wrestle in the Central Illinois area for Pro Wrestling Glory. She has roots in Decatur, but has never had the chance to wrestle here. That will change on October the 5th, as she will be going one-on-one against the 2012 Diamond in the Rough winner, Serenity, Bree Allison. We recently caught up with both combatants. Let's hear from them now.
Bree Allison. I suggest you make your bucket list and fulfill it, because October 5th, it's you and me. Enough said.
All right.
I won't do it.
You have to do it. We got a whole month. No, you're going to do
it.
You're the only woman this town knows.
I'm not
going to
do it.
You're not losing.
No,
she's out of
I'm
shape.
Not.
We
I'm
will
not
do
doing
this.
It.
No, you're going to do it.
No.
You don't have a choice, Bree.
No, I'm not doing
this. This is what happens in wrestling.
Are you kidding me?
You're going to do it. You have to do this.
spoil it?
Wait, listen to me. You're gonna do this and you're gonna win. This is what you have to do. We will beat her.
Are you sure I can beat her?
I know together we will beat her. I don't care about WWE, I don't care about TNA. This is Maroa and we fight dirty. We will beat Kharma.
Okay, we'll be here.
We're gonna beat her.
It happens at the Maroa City Hall at 120 South Locust Street in Maroa, Illinois. Go to ProWrestlingGlory.com for all the details. Pro Wrestling Glory at the Maroa City Hall on October the 5th.
And to close out this edition of the Nosebleed Seats, we talk with the Pro Wrestling Glory Heavyweight Champion and a triple title holder.
Like Steel, for a few hours, you had four championship belts around your waist. That was a couple of weeks ago in Waynesville. Now you're down to, back down to three. But you've been making your way all around the state, and you ventured up to Wisconsin. Tell us about your recent exploits.
Yeah, I was up in Wisconsin actually last night. It's Friday. This is Saturday. Went up there for Fourth Wall Wrestling. Worked Silas Young. Really good match. Really enjoyed it.
How did you... Well, tell us what happened in that match up there with Silas.
He's a machine, and I kept up with him, and he had respect for me afterwards, and he's definitely a really good match. I'm gonna be uploading that up on my YouTube channel here pretty soon.
Okay, and your YouTube channel is
Blasteel 1, BLASTEEL 1.
Okay,
so make sure you go subscribe to that.
So tell us what's been happening lately in the Apex's world.
Well, I got some guys I'm training actually in Springfield. I got like a couple guys. I got some guys that have been working for a while. They're working on with me. We train at least 2-3 times a week, you know. So that's real nice. If you want to get a hold of me for training, if you're serious about it, please contact me. We always love having you guys come down.
That is by appointment only. You don't actually have a wrestling school opened up.
Yeah, not like an actual full-on facility and stuff, but for what we got weights, we've got where we can tape matches and stuff, you know, for guys to be able to see what they do, and it's just really, really awesome. You can sit there and watch what you just did in the ring and be able to learn from your mistakes like right there, you know what I mean? So that's really nice.
Do you want to do, I say, plug any students close to making their debuts?
Well, I don't really have. I got a few. They're still about a month or two off, so I'm not going to say much about them. I got Nelson Six. He's been training with me, and he's been coming 2-3 times a week, and he's, I'm telling you, he's going to be good, really good.
All right,
Dad. Yeah, he is, but watch out for him.
Right now, your main feud, I would say, is with the Brandon Espinoza. You've been, as I said earlier, you traded the belt back and forth with him in Waynesville. Looks like you're gonna have another showdown with him relatively soon. So tell us.
Yeah, it's October.
In Lincoln. They got you pictured as Iron Man or something.
Right. I know exactly what you're talking about. I wanna make sure I get that date right.
Well, I will flash it across the bottom of the screen, as
October
I always
11th.
Do.
Lincoln, PWE, Brandon Espinoza versus Blake Steel, Iron Man match.
You're the Pro Wrestling Glory Heavyweight Champion. Now you're seemingly, after getting one of the belts off of Guy Smith,
yeah.
Now dealing with Tom Arson.
Yeah, a whole line of guys in that locker room. I want a piece of Blake Steel, too.
Piece of Blake Steel, yes. You also got the regional title in PWA.
Yeah.
That match with Guy Smith, I thought, was belt for belt. Somehow it got changed to non-title.
Yeah, but we went 20 minutes anyways. You didn't beat me, so we'll see what happens later on down the road. We'll definitely lock up again, I'm sure.
Now, the biggest variety of opponents you've been facing is over at Proving Ground Pro.
Yeah.
You had a bull rope match with one Rough Crossing.
Correct.
Strategically winning the matches, or winning that match, using your foot to tag each corner.
Yeah.
When he tagged each corner.
Well, you know, win's a win. But hey, I would say this: Rough Crossing is a rough son of a gun. He whooped me. I did not come out of that unscathed. That's for sure. That's definitely sure.
Some of you, tell us about some of the other opponents that you faced lately, and what your thoughts about them.
Well, man, I can't put over Silas Young enough. That was amazing working him. I've worked with Nelson Six quite a bit. We've been on the road, so I've got to work him a couple times. And you know, like I said, he's getting really good. You know, I always like working Guy Smith. Jimmy Carrot's another guy I always like working. I always have great chemistry with him. There's a lot of guys that I do really enjoy. I do enjoy having matches with SB. I don't really, you know, we don't seem to get along, but you know, I enjoy the matches that we have.
Now it's looking like you may be one of the finalists for the Wrestler of the Year award. Oh. By virtue of winning all those championships, and I don't know, it's looking like a belt race to the finish line.
We'll see what happens on BW.
How many belts do you think you can capture and hold at the same time?
I don't know. How long are my arms and how big are the straps? I think I could probably fit quite a few on there.
Is there any targets you have on your radar that may not immediately be obvious?
Yeah. I might be heading up north here pretty soon. You're going to see me some places here pretty soon, so I'm looking forward to that. I don't want to tell too much about it, you know, but...
Is there any promotion that you'd like to appear for that you haven't?
Yeah, I'm pretty much open for anything, you know. Anybody wants to contact me, use me, check out my matches on YouTube and stuff, and if you like what you see, get a hold of me. But yeah, I'm open for anything. Like I said, I don't want to give away too much about what's going on in the future, but you know, we'll see what happens.
What about a dream match?
Dream match? Like The Rock or Cena Mania.
Yeah, everybody's going to say a WWE guy or a TNA guy, but
Mania.
Closer to home.
Okay.
In the Midwest.
Or Hulk. I could do Hulk too.
Hulk doesn't even wrestle anymore,
I'd do it.
Nobody in the Midwest.
No, well, I wouldn't say that. Like, I dream about wrestling like day and night, so yeah, pretty much everybody's a dream opponent for me. I love this shit, so.
Oops. Any possibility of bringing back Eric Ruffington and reforming feature presentation?
You never know. That's all I can really say about that. You never know. Never say never. I mean, all we gotta do is put it back together and take over again. I mean, it wouldn't be much, I don't think.
We'll see. Or promote go if they want to bring Blake Steele.
You can contact me on my Facebook page, my Twitter at Steel Apex. You know, you can get a hold of me through email, blaharney@hotmail.com. Hopefully you can put that up there too. Put all my stuff up there right there. Don't cover up my face though.
All right, Blake Steele, thank you very much.